According to our belief, anyone who calls himself to be a Muslim has a right to call himself a Muslim. And no one has a right to declare him a non-Muslim against his own profession. This is what I have learned from the Holy Quran. The Holy Quran speaks of munafiqeen and tells Hazrat Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alayhi wa sallam that munafiqeen bear witness to your truth. Annaka Rasulullah. Wallahu yashhadu annaka Rasulullah. Wallahu ya'lamu annaka Rasulullah. Wallahu yashhadu annal munafiqeen al-qazibun. Allah knows better than anybody else that you are His prophet. Yet these munafiqeen who declare you are Allah's Rasul, they are liars. They don't believe you to be Allah's Rasul. Yet, as far as their right to claim themselves Muslims is concerned, the Holy Quran says, قَالَتِ الْأَعْرَابُ أَعْمَنَّا قُلْ لَمْ تُؤْمِنُوا وَقْبَلْ قُولُوا أَسْلَمْنَا وَلَكِنْ قُولُوا أَسْلَمْنَا. The Arab declare that they have become mu'mineen, they are believers. In another verse, the Holy Quran says, لَمَّا يَدْخُلِ الْإِيمَانُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ. Iman has not even peeped into your hearts. It has not entered the hearts. Yet these people who are declared to be non-believers, they are not deprived of calling themselves Muslim. On the contrary, the Holy Quran says, قُلُوا أَسْلَمْنَا. There is no harm. The second proof in favor of this interpretation is that in the entire lifetime of Hazrat Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not a single person was deprived of the right of calling himself Muslim. Never once. So the right which Hazrat Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not exercise for himself, how can I exercise, or how can any other living being exercise on his own behalf? So we cannot call such a person as you have described as non-Muslim. But at the same time, you should realize that anybody who believes in Islam, who acts on Islam, who does everything according to Islam, but does not believe in Jesus Christ, what would be his position? If he does not believe in Jesus Christ, his time is over. He's not concerned with Islam anymore. What is the harm? Yet even if he rejects a single prophet of God in the sight of Allah, he is not a Muslim, true Muslim at all. He may continue to call himself whatever he likes. But if there is an imam appointed by God, everybody must accept him. If he does not, whether the followers of the imam call him a Muslim or non-Muslim, it is irrelevant. Because Allah will not accept anyone's faith if He has sent an imam Himself and someone dares to reject him. The question has a big if, of course. If we are right in believing in Imam Mahdi to be the imam appointed by God, anyone who rejects, God will not be happy with him. God will not favor him. Because anyone who rejects the imam appointed by God, how can Allah love him?